straighten it out. For some reason it's tilted. Can you hear me? If you can hear me, let me know. Mary, Greg, Linda, anybody? Talk to me. If you post your comments, I can see it right now before I get in front of the camera. Thank you. We're going live. New moon. Virtual. I don't know if this is reality or not anymore. What I'm going to do afterwards is I will take a couple of shots of the grid I set up for tonight. Unfortunately, I can't get the screen further away for you to see it.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Virtual New Reality. Starting in just a couple of minutes here, as I just get my last minute adjustments done. I want to thank you for joining me. Some of you have joined my streams before. This is the first time I'm actually doing it as an intended live stream. Usually I have a live audience, and as an afterthought I stream it. But due to the circumstances, with the situation with the world, we have to be safe. So normally I would be doing a new moon gong bath tonight in my studio, but I felt we need to send it out to the world. There is a grid in front. You can probably see part of it. I couldn't get the camera to get everything that I wanted it to show. So I did the best I could within the limitations of my studio. I can tell you a little bit about it. It's a full moon grid per se, but it's also a healing grid. It's about bringing in the energy to help us transition into this new reality we're all dealing with. Ganesh is a goddess, a god of overcoming obstacle, an elephant-headed god. There's a whole story about that, but I'm not going to get into that. There are two clay star globes with candles inside to help bring light in. In the center of the grid is the Buddha's hands holding a selenite crystal ball. And there are various stones out, celestite, sodalite, rose quartz, tektite, selenite wands, clear quartz, amethyst, jasper, ammonite, moonstone, and then there's a chakra pyramid, kind of framing the whole thing. There are seven pyramids for the seven chakras: amethyst, sodalite, clear quartz, adventure, green aventurine, citrine or golden aventurine, I can't remember exactly, sorry, I have to go check that, rose quartz, and red jasper. And then the jaguar head is in the center, it's for enlightenment, and to get us to see past what we see in front of us, to get us to see with more of our intuition. The gongs are, the large gong in the center is the 48-inch Chinese chow. The two smaller gongs hanging to either side of it are Nepalese shaman gongs from Mustang. To my left, I guess it would be your left also, on top, on the left side, is the 26-inch Chinese wind gong. Below it is a 28-inch Nepalese wind gong. And then in the decorative round stand is a 22-inch Chinese hang gong. On the other side is a 40-inch Nepalese wind gong. And then the two shaped gongs, which are a little hard to see from the angle you guys are at. There's a triangular gong from Italy, known as a fire gong. And the lower gong is the water gong. It's kind of a semicircle. We're in a new paradigm, a new shift of energy and consciousness. This virus, or what's going on, has opened up a whole new stream of consciousness and reality for a lot of people. Obviously, things have not been going correctly or right or the way we all thought it was. I'm not quite sure what's going on myself. All I know is in a blink of an eye, everything has shifted, everything has changed. And I really appreciate you tuning in tonight for tonight's event. I don't know if it's on the screen at the bottom, but I have a virtual tip jar. If you feel compelled to help donate so I can keep my doors open here at the studio, I appreciate it. Go to PayPal. My email is fdicristina, so it's fdicristina at comcast.net. Literally anything will help. These are really trying times for all of us. My work is based on working with people personally. So if people can't come to my studio, I have to come up with other ways to keep the business alive. So this was one of them. And I appreciate it. I will be putting out more videos. I will have a YouTube channel I'm working on. If you go to Frank DeCristina on YouTube, please subscribe there. When I get 1,000 subscribers, then I can go live there. Otherwise, I'm going to be posting videos and broadcasting those at a later time. I actually prefer to do live. I prefer to do live in person because there's an energy exchange in the room, in the place I play, that really helps me to connect. That doesn't mean I don't connect now with who's out there and who's watching. It's just, there's an exchange. And those that have been to my events, you know, live, know what I'm talking about. It's hard to explain what happens when you're here at the studio or when you're here at a space when I put all these instruments up. This one here I decided to use all gongs. I'll be doing another one very shortly with just singing bowls. And then obviously combinations of, I have other instruments I play also, but this one here, I felt like we needed a gonging. We needed a good gonging. And I have many friends out there that I know and love and respect that are excellent gong players. And the gonging community is actually, we're discussing trying to figure out how to do a global gonging where we all can gong together. Many people suggested Zoom, the online conferencing app. That doesn't work with gongs, but for some reason the Zoom app thinks that it's noise or there's an issue, so it cuts the gongs out. That's why this is not a Zoom broadcast. We're looking at other venues. YouTube is one of them, but like I said, YouTube, until I have enough subscribers, I can't do a live broadcast. So that being said, I have to look at other ones. We're looking at Twitch, and there's a couple others out there. And once I figure that all out, we will get that connected. We'll get it fed over to Facebook and all the different outlets that people view on. It's a new moon tonight, so that means new beginnings. We get a chance to start over again, and that's okay. You know, maybe what's happening is some people, I've talked to a lot of people about this. Maybe it's the matter of the earth or the system, you know, the organic system, the breathing matrix, is finally said, you know, we need to put you in time out. The human race needs to go in time out for a little bit. And you know what, that's okay. Because obviously if we were warned, and obviously we were warned, this has been building for some time, and all of a sudden it's come to a situation where we're forced to take that immediate time out and take a break. Hopefully, when this all settles down and this dissolves and the new normal, whatever that is, that we'll learn something from this. And maybe we start with taking care of the planet and taking care of ourselves. One of the wonderful things that I've heard about is people coming together. Even though we can't, just wonderful. I heard a story of an animal shelters completely being emptied out so that the animals that were waiting for adoption all had a home to go to, so there was no worry, you know, that the animals would be stressed out, because believe it or not, they get used to having people come by because they don't know what's going on. They're locked up in cages, just like we're locked up in our houses, and they need that human contact. We need that human contact. Sure, we got social media, and we got video games, and we got all this stuff, but we need to be connected to each other. And hopefully, when this all settles down, that we have a greater appreciation for each other. And there you go. That's my take on it. So I'm going to play. If you have headphones, put them on. If you have a decent speaker system, crank it up. If there are any glitches or problems, my apologies. We've worked on this all afternoon trying to make sure everything was just perfect. Again, I haven't done this like this before. But we hope that it goes pretty smoothly. Lay back, close your eyes, meditate, take deep breaths. And if you fall asleep, that's okay, because you still get what you need out of it anyway. The nice thing about this is once we post it, it'll be up there in the cloud, you can call it Facebook, wherever. It'll be up there forever, so if you want to go back to it. And again, we'll be adding more. We'll be doing more streams, different streams. I'm also going to work on some classes.
more information, and a podcast. I'll be a guest on the podcast, and I'll have maybe a series or show or something. I don't know. We're working out those details too. So I can give you more information about what this is all about. One thing I can tell you is the bronze, the metal, is really good as a healing energy itself. Viruses don't live very long on copper. And large component of bronze is copper. And actually, quality bronze has quality copper, so it's actually better than just, you know, your regular dishes, you know, if you have brass or dishes or vases. So I can't tell you the bronze are going to kill viruses. That would be misinformation. But I can tell you if a virus landed on one of my bronze gong, it's not going to last there very long. So I'll let you put that one together. And if you don't believe me, look it up. Look up copper and viruses. You can Google it up. There's lots of medical papers on the healing power of copper. You don't necessarily have to ingest it. Singing bowls are made of bronze also, especially the ones I get from Nepal. They're very good also. And again, I'm not telling you if they're going to kill the virus. I'm just telling you that if a virus got on the material, the metal, a bronze or copper or brass versus stainless steel or nickel silver or other types of metal, the virus will not live as long on a bronze gong than it will on a stainless or a nickel silver gong. Okay? So that's some healing power right there. The vibrations are very healing also. The thing is about gongs and sound therapy and singing bowls is the brain has a way of identifying or not identifying, depending on the person, which is how you end up relaxing. So if you're very high strung, gongs are awesome at calming you down because they'll get to that spot in your brain that's just clicking along because you're so fired up. And it kind of like, the best way to call it, we entrain with the energy, we entrain with the mind, and we start to calm it down. And that's what I love about playing the gongs and playing the bowls, is it's a very calming and healing effect, because the first thing we need to do to heal is we need to reduce our stress level. And number one thing gongs and bowls do, they help reduce the stress level. So by reducing your stress level, you are boosting your immune system. So I want everybody to get settled in. Take a deep breath in through the nose, slowly out through the mouth. Another deep breath in, through the nose. More. Lastly, I want you to know about the lighting here. I've studied spectrochrome therapy, which is using colored light as a healing modality, and the lighting colors that were chosen are the colors of sunlight. So, and the reason we chose that is we need sunlight. We need the energy of the sun also. So I'm adding that into the frequency that I'm broadcasting out, that we're bringing sunlight to everybody also. So if you're locked up and it's still cold and miserable where you are, we're bringing sunlight into you also. The object is to get you the healing energy you need. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.